Welcome back for another video. My name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make videos for non-techies. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you how to create a menu on your WordPress-based website, and you're also going to learn how to adjust the menu if you already have a WordPress website and you don't know how to change the different menu items. So the first step is to log into your WordPress website and then go to where it says Appearance and then click on Menus right there. Now, depending on your website and the theme you have on your website, or is it an existing website, we're all going to see something a little different. So for me, I just recently installed a theme called GeneratePress, and I haven't created any menus, so this is what WordPress is showing me by default. Now, typically what we do is we create our menus, and you can have as many different menus as you want, because typically there'll be multiple locations that you can assign a menu to in your theme. So it's going to change and vary by theme, how many different menu areas you get. So typically, you're gonna have a header or a primary or a top menu area, and you might also, with your theme, have a footer area. Now, we can also create menus that we put in things called widgets in the sidebar, and I'm gonna show you how to do that as well. So for me, I don't have any menus created, and for some reason, it's just showing me some of these prior created pages, because it probably figures I'm going to want to use some of these prior created pages. So I'm going to name this menu, and let's just name it top or primary. How about that? And then I'm going to click on create menu. So now I have a menu, and these are the menu items that are in this menu. Now, when you scroll down to this area right here, this is where you can assign these menus to different locations. You can see that the theme that I have, the only location it gives me an option is the primary menu, which is, I already know, is going to be the top header area of this website. Now, creating a menu is simple. All it is you've got these items right here on the left, and you drag them or you select them and they appear on the right, and then you order them here. It's pretty simple, and you can also have sub items. So let's see, I've got home, and I probably would want services to appear before that. So I'm gonna drag services up like that. Now, if you didn't notice, I can drag it off to the right a little, and then it becomes a sub item, which would be appearing when there's a drop down. So your user would hover over the menu item and this drop down items would appear. But I don't want drop down items. I usually don't like that. So I'm going to put that there. So I probably want about us, and then maybe the contact us, and then the blog. Actually, how about this? We'll do it like that, and it looks like I've got a duplicate entry in here. So this is how you would remove a menu item. You would click on it like this, and it'll appear some additional options, and then you can click on remove, and that would remove it right there, and then click on save menu. So now I've got this menu, and I have gone ahead and selected it and assigned it to the primary menu location. So essentially, the options you're given for menu items are simple. Here's the different pages you've created on your website, and it shows you your most recent, but you can click view all, and it's just going to show you all of your pages right there. Okay, and you can also search if your website has lots of pages. You can also just do a simple search for the pages that you want. And then you've got posts. These are your different news items and things like that. Typically, you probably wouldn't use a post as a menu item, but you have that option. And then you can have a custom link, so you can name it whatever you want to name it and then put a URL. So say I wanted a link to Google. I would name it and then I would put the URL here. And I would click add to menu, and then it just adds it right there. And then you have categories, and these are if you're using the blog post feature of your website and you're categorizing your blog posts into categories, they will appear here. I actually use this feature on a lot of my websites. Now, depending on the plugins that you have installed on your website or the theme, you might have additional items here that you can use to create menu items. It all depends on the theme or the plugins that you happen to have installed on your site. Now, like I said, you can rearrange these. You can also rename them once they've already been moved over here to the side. So if I can show the panel there, right here I can change the name to whatever I want for this menu item. But I'm just going to go ahead and remove it. Then I'm going to click on Save Menu. So now I'm going to go to the front end of my website. You can see here's my menu area. I'm going to go ahead and click on refresh. And now we have those different menu items that I put in there. And that's pretty much all there is to it. Now here's your sidebar widget area. I'm going to show you how to put a menu in there. And if you scroll down, I've got this footer area, and you could put different menus there as well. So let me show you how to do that. So that is going to be widgets. So if I go ahead and click on widgets, here's the different widget areas that my theme offers. Your theme will probably have entirely different widget areas. So what I'm going to do is, here's the sidebar. I'm going to go ahead and take this custom menu widget, and I'm going to put it there at the top. Let's just name it main menu or something like that. And then I'm going to choose from my list of menus. You saw I only have one. That's the primary menu. I'm going to click on save. So now when I go to the front end and click on refresh, you should see that menu right there. Now I'm going to put it here in the footer for you. So let's just actually move it. I'm going to move it to the footer one area like this. Drag and drop it. Now when I go here and I click refresh, it's going to be gone from here because I moved it. But if I scroll down, you're going to see it there. So a lot of times if you go to larger websites, they have different menus listed here that are linking to different pages on their website that they feel that they want a shortcut to. And I can also remove this header here, I believe. Let's see what happens. If I didn't name it main menu and I click on save, I wonder if it's just going to get rid of that and show me the links. There it is. So you can see how you can easily duplicate this for these two widget areas here, and you can have links down there. And so that's pretty much all there is to having a menu, multiple menus, putting those menus wherever you want them. Now your themes are going to have different styling of these menus, and that's different from creating the menu. I know for the theme I'm using right now, GeneratePress, it gives me the option to center it and move it here. I'll just show you real quick. It's under this Customize tab, and then I can go right here to the Layout, and then right here it says Primary Navigation. And so right now the position is below this area, but I can, I can align to the left, I could put it to the center if I wanted, and I can move this to the center if I wanted. But there's also all these other locations where I could put this menu. I could put it to this area right here, and you can see now it has taken up less height on the screen, and it's a pretty good location, although we'd probably want to change this black background and make it the same color as the background there. But you get the point. There's all these different places where I can put it, and this is a theme by theme setting. It's not for every theme. It's going to be a little different. So anyways, the main point of this video I accomplished. I wanted to show you how to create a menu in your WordPress based website. Hey, before you go, I have something for you, and before I get into that, I wanted to ask you to do something for me. If you could give me a thumbs up on this video, and if you're not a subscriber, click on the subscribe button right beneath me. If you have a question on this video, I'd be happy to answer it. You can also leave a comment or a question down below this video. Hey, I put together a course just for you, and I'm going to give it to you for free. All you have to do is click on the button right here on the right. It's called the 3 Steps to WordPress Success. It's an awesome course. You're gonna love it. I would love for you to join in and enroll as a student in this course. Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it, and I do it just for you.